Normal Albertans bust up a rail blockade in the most polite and Canadian way possible. Not all heroes wear capes. Some wear work boots. That's a clip of severely normal Albertan men, the kind who wear work gloves, work boots, and fire-retardant coveralls, showing up to fix the problem of rail blockaders, anti-oil protesters that no politicians nor the police seem very effective or all that interested in dealing with. A blockade that went up in the morning was down by just after lunch. Just like that. The rail blockading protesters claim to be in solidarity with the Wetsuweten people against the Coastal GasLink pipeline in northern British Columbia. However, true solidarity would mean supporting the pipeline because the democratically elected Wetsuweten Band Council and 8 of 13 hereditary chiefs all support Coastal GasLink going forward. Let's be perfectly clear here. This was not an Indigenous protest, despite the fact that there's actually a pretty big nearby First Nations reserve very close to the protest site. However, the Enoch First Nation is pretty oil and gas friendly. They have a couple of gas stations even, and they're focused on economic development. No, this thing west of Edmonton yesterday was reportedly organized with the help of Climate Justice Edmonton, a bunch of busybodies, spoiled urban do-gooders, and it was promoted online by a Twitter account called Cousins for Wetsuweten. And frankly, not going to lie, I found that Twitter account quite hilarious because they were set up to be brave earth defenders, you know, the kind of people who can live off the land without oil and gas, and yet they put out a call for chairs, food, firewood, music, and camping supplies, the basic necessities of life, I guess. Now, first thing yesterday morning, when they got wind that a blockade was happening in Edmonton, the pro-oil and gas, pro-freedom, pro-Canadian economy folks from United We Roll started to mobilize their trucks to come up from central Alberta to Edmonton to stage their own counter-protest. And boy, did that ever freak out the blockaders. In fact, I would put my money on it hastening their departure from their little rail line sit-in. Now, by the time United We Roll got to the protest site, it had already been cleared away by some Alberta heroes. But I did run into Glen Carritt, the organizer of United We Roll, in the evening at a truck stop in West Edmonton, and this is what Glen had to say. Glen, you organized a convoy up to the blockade on mere hours' notice. Why?
Well, because we're still fighting for oil and gas, and these people that come and put illegal blockades in Alberta is not going to be tolerated. We're not going to have our infrastructure, our railways, or our roadways blocked for any length of time. So we thought we could wait till Friday or Thursday, but then we said, you know what? We don't want to give them any momentum or any time to have this blocked, because that's what the police should be doing. They should be taking those down immediately. They shouldn't be allowed to be up. So we want to show that Alberta is ready to fight, and we hope that the rest of Canada sees that this can be done, and let's get these barricades taken down.
You know, that was one thing that I thought was the real takeaway today was probably for the rest of the country, that when the police aren't acting, when our politicians are doing nothing but actually legitimizing these people by agreeing to negotiate with them, normal people are going to step up. And I noticed when you guys announced that you were coming up, the Twitter account for the protest, it went frantic. They were horrified that you guys were coming, and by the time you guys got here, they had already gone.
Yeah, and that's right. And we set it out, I think it was 9 o'clock this morning, we put a post out, and we got, in 4 hours, we had over 50,000 hits on it, views on it. So, you know, we've got a huge support, and they were concerned, and there's actually people following us that we believe are with the group, taking pictures and phoning it ahead for them to get warned about us coming up. So there's no doubt that United Roll for Canada had a major part in them coming down. The police didn't want any confrontation. We're not about confrontation, but they realize that we're here to stand up for oil and gas and our rights, and we can't have a lawless state.
You know, I think how the people who were on site, who dealt with the problem today, the locals that showed up with the trailer and took everything down. I think they dealt with it in exactly the right way. They were polite, they said, excuse me, and then they just moved all the junk right out of the way.
Yeah, absolutely, and that's what needs to be done. These guys, these protesters are setting up, you know, by themselves or doing whatever, and it's against the law, so who's stopping us from removing them? So let's continue to keep fighting for what we believe in and keep our railways open. And, you know, we lost 1,000 jobs with CN, temporary job loss, and that's unacceptable. We can't have this kind of action in a free country, in a first world country.
Now, you guys, even though the protests had been broken up by the time you got there, you still went for a victory lap. And I was watching your live stream with great interest. The cars belonging to the protesters, they got out of there, like, they split so fast that they left their cars behind and they were being towed.
Yeah, I think, you know what, that when they hear that, you know, that there's some angry oil and gas workers coming and standing up for what we believe in, I think they realize that, and you know what, we were going to come and have dialogue, do whatever, and see how it went, but, you know, I think that's what they got to realize, that there's a lot of other people. We're the silent majority, but you know what, you're waking up a sleeping giant, because we're done. We're not gonna stand by anymore and take our infrastructure being shut down.
You know, I think that's the thing with these protesters. This stuff, it might fly in BC, it might fly in Ontario, heck, it might even fly in Montreal, but this is a province that has been under attack for 5 years. People are unemployed and they've had it.
Absolutely, they've had it. And you know, our economy's been stifled, like you said, for the last 5 years. And for us to go through one more day, two more days of any kind of a shutdown economy, people can't afford it. They need to get to work. And the other thing is, anybody that says that this is a peaceful protest has to realize there is nothing peaceful about blocking off a railway or a roadway. That is not peaceful. You may think it's peaceful, but you're shutting down an economy. You're keeping farmers from getting food. You're keeping people from getting their medicine. You're keeping water supplies from getting their chlorine. It's not peaceful, and nobody should accept that for being peaceful.
Well, Glen, I want to thank you again for taking the time to meet me. We're meeting at a truck stop west of Edmonton in the evening. But I want to thank you for being so quick to drop everything and speak up for normal people.
Yeah, you know, I want to give a shout out to my partner, Haley Weil, because
yes,
she's always, you know, she wants to, she's great. And I, you know, sometimes I'm wondering the logistics a little bit, and she wants to go, and she pushes, and I appreciate that. But we're, you know, we're a team, and we roll, and we're going to keep doing it. If they put up another blockade, we'll be right there, because we can't stand for this in Alberta. And I wish I could go across the country and help everybody else, but geographically it's going to be tough.
You know what, though? Maybe what you did today will send a message to other parts of the country that they can help themselves.
Yeah, I think so. You know, that's exactly right. Just band together and be a unified force, and we can shut down this illegal protesting.
Glen, thank you, and keep fighting for freedom.
Thank you, Sheila.
Now, I'm very proud of what a few good Albertans that I don't even know accomplished yesterday west of Edmonton. These sorts of infrastructure blocking protests, they might fly in the rest of the country, but Albertans, we're a can-do people. We don't sit by and wait for politicians or the government to solve our problems. We'd be waiting forever if we did that. We can solve our problems ourselves, and we can even be respectful when we do it. Some protesters from Edmonton were taught a lesson about what people are like outside of that cloistered, progressive bubble of the capital city. And maybe yesterday afternoon, on some train tracks west of Edmonton, the rest of the country learned a lesson, too, about how to take care of themselves. For Rebel News, I'm Sheila Gunn Reid. Hey, did you know that Rebel News is going on a cruise? Yes, we're going to Alaska on Independence Day, July 4th. We would love to invite you to come with us to see all the details, to get pricing, to see the beautiful ship with the incredible amenities. Please go to rebelnewscruise.com.